It feels like Christmas here at Wild Horse with a red car and a green car on the starting line. Brad Burton is a two-time champion, and he is driving that Firebird. He is a Division V hitter that went through school, got his engineering degree, moved up to Washington, started working for Boeing, and pretty much everybody in Division V said, good riddance. The problem is he keeps coming back. Jon Irving in the right side, second-generation racer in that lime green, fuselage-bodied 73 Plymouth Satellite. Handicap head start goes to the right lane. 7/10 of a second later, the red car will stand up and be on the chase for the trophy in stock Eliminator, and away we go. Jon Irving out in front, trying to hold off a two-time world champion down to the stripe. It's a breakout for Irving, and Brad Burton wins it. He goes 10.75. He goes 109 miles an hour, and he'll go to the winner's circle for the ninth time.
Yeah, I mean, and then before that, obviously, the wreck that happened, it always takes a racer kind of out of his game a little bit. But, you know, got to strap in, put the helmet on and suit up. And I knew when I left, I wasn't stellar on the tree, so you really have one decision as a driver, and that's just to give it up, and it worked out my way.
So some of these fans aren't exactly familiar with stock Eliminator racing and the head start and all that stuff, so when you talk about making the decision down there, explain to the fans exactly what you're talking about.
Okay, yeah, so I had a 10.74 on the window, figured I'm holding about 3 or 4, meaning I think I'm going to go with 70. Obviously, I can't cross in front and be under because that's a breakout, so when it's getting tight down there and you don't think you can kill what you need to, you just drop it hard and hopefully it works out.
Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for your stock Eliminator champion. He's a bad dude in stock. Pretty good in super stock too. Brad Burton, everybody, big round of applause.